Carnival is sort of in my DNA. I grew up in the Mecca of Carnival, which is in Port of Spain, Trinidad, and Trinidad is considered the Mecca of Caribbean Carnival.
The joys of Notting Hill Carnival. This is the time when you wonder if it's really worth it.
We tried going in there, but the water is coming into the van.
This is Carnival, you know?
Rum is a part of creative culture.
The rum. There's not one day that I prefer better than the other. I think they're both really exciting.
So Sunday, colors on Sunday is what we call Juve.
I get a bit savage with the paint.
I'm looking forward to, you know, when the music's so loud that you can actually, if you touch your chest, you can feel the vibrations of the sound systems.
Carnival to, I think, any Caribbean island is truly a way of life. It is not something that we kind of, it's not a tangible thing. It's ridiculously ingrained in us in kind of every sense of the word.
So Colours essentially is a Carnival mass band, a Notting Hill Carnival mass band. But we also do different events like concerts, etc. So it's called Colours for various reasons. Mainly Colours represents the Caribbean, if you like. The sunshine, you know, the sea, the vegetation. I can go as far as to say the people. We've got quite a colorful people in the Caribbean when it comes to their attitudes, their way of life. It also represents, colors also represents the diversity of Caribbean people. We have all races there, mixed races, where we all, we all live in harmony. Initially, when I came up here from Trinidad and Tobago, that's where I'm from, that's where my parents are from as well. My dad, he's an avid pan player, steel pan player, which is part of Carnival as well. Where we lived in Port of Spain, at a tender age, I was exposed to Carnival, mass band. You know, when you're small, you're seeing all the folk characters, the devils and, all of these things. And every year I looked forward to Carnival as growing up. And that followed on coming into London. Carnival to me in the UK is a way of us Caribbean people, including myself. It's a way of us showing the world what we as a Caribbean people are about. It's about freedom of expression from every level of society. We all come together, whether you are, whatever level you are, status you are in society, we all come together as one, behind one band. We all wear the same apparel, same costumes, and
Well, Colours Carnival here, as you can see, there's a bit of a disaster there going to the truck site.
Darren.
We tried going in there, but the water is coming into the van. So we're gonna try to see what we can do. You know, we always make things happen. So we're gonna see if we can get a truck to come out here.
Well, the cab as it is, the cab is too low. The truck itself would go, but water is gonna come into the cab. So that's the problem we have here now. But this is Carnival, you know. We will make something happen.
There's a lot of stuff there, Siobhan. So what you need to do is keep it down there. We'll bring it to the truck on Sunday morning. The trucks are gonna be parked at Bayswater car park. Coach park tonight. Tonight. The truck is coming down there tonight.
Park the car outside.
So I'll just take it to there tonight.
Take it there tonight, yeah.
Okay. All right, I'm gonna have to unload the car then. The whole car's packed. I've got to go.
Yeah, you gotta. That's the only thing is we just can't get through. It's impossible. The river, something the Thames pipe for the river is busted. I don't know what it is. All I see is a lot of water.
No,
okay, take it. Right.
Bye.
Is there another way around there?
No.
No.
After me is flood normally, after me is normally flood.
Well, tell me, got the front of the flood now. Is normally flood here?
Normally.
Do it normally flood?
Yeah, yeah. If yesterday they come and drain it.
Oh, they pumped it out?
They pumped it out yesterday.
So, is somebody going to come here now to pump it out?
I don't think so. Because the site is closed. There's nobody working now.
Can we arrange to get somebody to come and pump this out?
No, I don't think, I don't know. Yeah, we have your own managers. The managers need to arrange somebody to come in.
Okay, what's the number of the manager? Let me speak to the manager. Darren, let me call you back.
All right.
The joys of Notting Hill Carnival. This is the time when you wonder if it's really worth it. Unfortunately, there's a tunnel that goes to the site, and the tunnel, because of the high tides, the tunnel has flooded. So the van cannot get through with all the stuff on it. So we have to either wait for the tide to go down, or the truck drivers are coming here in about 45 minutes to actually bring the trucks out. So we need to be flexible. We are at Colours Carnival here. So we're going to go down to another site at Notting Hill Carnival, take all the trucks down to Notting Hill Carnival, and we are going to complete our operation.
With Notting Hill Carnival, we, as mass bands, we finance our own mass bands to bring them out, to put a show on. Unlike other events, you know, we actually, as mass band, we have to finance, pay for a band to put it out to entertain everyone. This year, we were lucky that we had various sponsors, including Havana Club. Yeah, so, to make things a bit easier.
Oh, I got this pillow at my house. It's like my couch, fam. Except this couch is like £3,000 and mine's like 30 quid from Argos. I'm Liam. I'm the cultural brand ambassador for Havana Club in the UK. Havana Club is a Cuban rum. We are kind of one of the, I would say, more premium Cuban rums around. My dad will hate me for saying that because I'm half Trini. And obviously, Trinis are very serious about their rum.
We have, we are fortunate that we have quite a bit of prospective sponsors that knock our door every year. But the way we choose a sponsor is on relevance. Havana Club, we consider ourselves a premium band. Ultimate band. We would not go with a brand that we don't consider premium.
Havana Club as a brand, we've been really trying to activate and engage with black and brown culture within the UK.
Trinidad and Tobago, the Caribbean, is about rum, is about sweetness, is about sugarcane. This is what it is, you know, and we chose Havana Club, we selected Havana Club among other sponsors for that, precisely that reason.
I feel like rum is a part of creative culture massively in the Caribbean and also in the UK. So to kind of find some of the most culturally forward-thinking, relevant, happening entities and try and engage with them and support them and kind of add value to their journeys, Colours made sense. Also, it's a bit of a personal touch for me because, like I said, I'm half Trini, so Roger is obviously Trinidad, Colours is a Trini mass band. So yeah, there's a personal touch there, but really and truly, it is we try to activate and engage with the culture in the right way and kind of add value to it.
Yo, how are you doing? You good?
I'm good.
Right, I'm just about to meet, running a bit late now, just about to meet Tamsin. She's our social media and marketing manager. I'm supposed to be meeting her at 3:30. It's now 4:00 or after 4:00, but it's been a long day today, tiring. Let's see. I have her waiting there for like 45 minutes, but I think she knows me by now. Hey, how are you going?
Thanks, how are you?
Sorry to be late.
That's fine, don't worry.
So how was distribution?
Yeah, it was really good actually, really good. We had so many customers come through the door, all really happy. Like this woman told me she had goosebumps looking at her costume. So no, I think people were really, really pleased and, you know, like to see it in person compared to the pictures.
Good.
Yeah, we still got a team there now. They're still doing last distribution today before everything goes off tomorrow. But yeah, no, it went really well.
So masqueraders are looking forward to Sunday.
Yeah, really. People tagging us already on socials, going, look what I got in my goodie bag. So it's really nice that we kind of got to give people, you know, the different businesses from the communities, like, you know, my Trini shop and, you know, We've got Satty's Pepper Shop, Cars Inclusive. So it's actually really nice that we're getting all these businesses from our communities up in the bags and giving them a platform.
Today, he's going to be leading the road today. So make sure you keep an eye on him today. He's going to be killing it. My ball runner Grace. So Grace is going to be running another float today. So you're going to see loads of beam and the light all over Carnival. But yeah, hope he's all ready.
Beam, we chose Beam as our security personnel for one of the main reasons is that we also advertise as the ultimate band for ultimate experience. For ultimate experience, we need to know that all masqueraders feel comfortable in a band, in the band. If I go back a bit, Beam, the head of Beam, Siobhan, a few years ago, I think it was in 2015, if I got that correct, we had other big security firms with us, Colours Carnival, and I got a phone call from this young lady, and she identified herself as Siobhan. So I said yes, I spoke to her. She said, listen, I want to provide you with security. I said, no problem. What do you have, any credentials? What are you, anything in the past? She said, yes, we did. We had some security at the Olympics and all that. I said, okay, no problem.
Pretty much confidently tell you anything that she's put to us as an opportunity has always been a good one. I trust her very much with all of the rum that we give her.
There's a vibration, I felt the vibes in her, I could feel it. All I told her is, listen, Siobhan, you're new here. There's nobody knows about you in Carnival itself. I'm going to give you a chance. Don't let me down. Siobhan has never let me down.
Hi, my name's called Shivs. I'm the director of Beam, and we're going to be working on the Colours and Havana float this year. So basically this year, what we've done is we've teamed up with Havana and Colours. And how we did that was, is that I've been working with Roger for years, I could say around 2015. And we started off and we've built things up. And the relationship that we've had is pretty much been the same with Havana that we've had with Colours, where we've always worked and built things up with them. So we started off with doing security and stewarding, and then from that, years later, we then brought some photographers, videographers. Then we thought, let's start this year off after COVID with getting some sponsor support. So Roger came to me and said to me that he really likes what we're doing with Havana, and Havana would be a really good match because they're a premium rum. So we then said it makes 100% sense. We've been working with Havana for about 5 years, and we thought that it would make so much sense to get Havana involved with Colours, because Colours are family. We've been working with them for a long period of time and the relationship's proper solid. This year at Carnival, we're doing the norm where we're securing the masqueraders. So we've got security and stewards. Then we've brought on media partners. We've also got some DJs, as well as we've done support in regards to staffing, as well as the planning and organization of how everything's gonna function on both days.
Oh, have you seen the flow?
My name is Sergio, and I've been designing, basically the visual representation of how everything comes out in terms of the menu, the actual bus, the wraparound, and yeah, anything graphic in terms of the posts, like links, anything like that, that's my responsibility.
Many of you may know me as Stormy J, but my real name's actually Storm, so legit. This Carnival, I'll be working with Beam. I'm the Beam TV and radio presenter. I'm looking forward to, when the music's so loud that you can actually, if you touch your chest, you can feel the vibrations of the sound systems. I'm looking forward to that. I'm looking forward to just being mad, just putting up against the dumper truck. Hey, the foods, meeting people that you would have never saw before, and the feeling of being around people where everyone's in such high spirits.
We're gonna be ready to move in about half an hour. We're gonna be moving. So we're just distributing some packages. We're good like that, you know, so. What's happening, guys? We're at Carnival, we're with Colours, we're with Havana Club, we're gonna punch mixing, we're gonna drinking, we're gonna music vibing, and we're good to go, man. It's gonna be a wicked day, it's gonna be a wicked weekend. Let's do this. Colours Carnival, you heard it here.
I think as a brand, Havana Club, we're really trying to kind of be a part of this journey with cultures and kind of entities such as Colours. In general, we are going to focus on possibly the most popular Notting Hill Carnival, or just carnival drink in the world, which is a punch, a rum punch. We're going to put our nice little Cuban spin on it. We're using Havana Club Cuban spice. I'm still yet to finalize the recipe with Roger, and obviously man needs to agree that it tastes good because it's his float, it's his party. But hopefully I've got some good recipes in mind, and I'm gonna show him a couple of them today, and we're gonna finalize on a recipe. We'll obviously do some kind of more Cuban style drinks to add to the menu. So we've got like some things like adding simple serves like ginger beer, Havana Club 7 in ginger beer, and even like a pineapple daiquiri, or even just a Cuba Libre, like a rum and coke.
So Sunday, Colours on Sunday is what we call Juve. So Juve is the beginning. And for Juve, we actually play paint. So it's a celebration with music, again behind the truck, and everyone we actually is covered in paint, play paint, different color play paint. Again, it expresses a color again.
It's been 2 years, 2 years since we've been able to do this, fam. It's Link Rock TV, it's Havana Club, it's Beam, it's Colours, we're out here.
During lockdown, you know, I said to myself, I said, you know what, good, this is a good break. Because for Notting Hill Carnival, a couple months before Notting Hill Carnival, we don't get sleep. So we say, yeah, it's a good break, I think. Yes, it's a good break. Coming up to the weekend of Notting Hill Carnival, it's like, you know, as we say in Trinidad, you're feeling a jumbie. You know, is that, you know, you want to come out here, you're really missing this thing.
Carnival, to I think any Caribbean island, is truly a way of life. It is not something that we kind of, it's not a tangible thing. It's ridiculously ingrained in us in kind of every sense of the word.
There's not one day that I prefer better than the other. I think they're both really exciting. I get a bit savage with the paint. I like chucking paint on people.
The Sunday is the first day, so yeah, I'm looking forward to it. You're starting off fresh. Monday you might be a bit more tired, but then it's also, for me, Monday is, you get really into it because it's the last day as well. Sunday's the first day, Monday's the last day, so I'm kind of like, they're both very special in their own way.
Carnival means so much. Like, for me personally, I'm from Guyana, I'm Guyanese, and I've traveled around the Caribbean.
So like my mum used to take me traveling all the time. And we used to go to like Notting Hill Carnival, so it played a big part of me growing up.
Anything around carnival culture and anything around that kind of music, that dance, that kind of liberation that you get out of carnival, it truly is Caribbean culture, and that means that kind of rings no truer.
Basically for me, I felt like when I set up Beam, I wanted to make sure that I was including culture in everything that we're doing, because I feel like it can be misrepresented sometimes. So I felt that by doing carnival, it's very important for us at Beam, because we want to represent the culture in the best way possible.
Good morning, Notting Hill Carnival. So this is another day, the final day, another 24 hours of no sleep. But we're looking forward here. We're running on pure adrenaline. You know, welcome to Colours Carnival. We're just in preparations now, so our masqueraders are having their breakfast at the moment. We're due to be moving in the next couple of hours. We're all excited out there. I think it's going to be a great day today.
Kind of, man. It's mad. Look, they're arguing because I'm putting them in a position today. Yeah.
The front's the best.
You want to be at the front?
Yeah.
Why do you want to be at the front of
like
carnival?
The front. It's
what,
like
what was that?
It's like
so it means you want to dance?
No, I like dancing.
All right, let's catch and see today, innit? Like, what's going on? But yeah, no, today, day two, it's going to be mad. As you can see, there's mad masqueraders coming through. So the fits are going to be crazy. And yeah, like, you're going to see, innit? It's our next team today still.
On Monday, we have what they refer to as pretty mass. So it's all about the costumes. There's a stronger team on Monday. So our team this year is Colors of the Caribbean. So we have sections in our band that represents the sea. We've got that represents the sun, you know, the vegetation, the riches of the Caribbean. Yeah, so that's Monday. It's not Juve anymore. You know, it's
literally, I've been going for, well, I'm 27 now, well, since I was about 3 years old. So minus the last 2 years because of lockdown, but it's something that is, I expect every year. So my granddad, he is one of the founding members of Ebony Steel Band, which is, he founded that in 1968. He used to practice with my grandma, my uncle, my grandma's cousin in their back garden shed, and they would wake up the whole street in West London where they lived, playing till all sorts of times in the morning on the steel pan. And it's something that's so heavily a part of my family history that it's just a no-brainer for me to go.
Yo, Daddy, he's there.
Yes, I'm good, we're here, carnival. Hey, it's big right now, it's big right
crazy,
now. Come
crazy.
On, got the flag, repping, repping.
What's your must for carnival today?
My must, just a lot of rum,
just
a lot of good vibes, and a lot of skanking, innit? You know what I'm saying? Sunset ting is the one, yeah, trust me. That's what you need, that's what you mean.
Rabbi, my friend, why you up? Why are you doing me like this?
Here it's carnival day two. If you can hear, I think I've lost my voice and the music's just stopped as we started filming, which is very, very nice of them. But I am having the best time. We're talking Havana Club, we're talking Beam family, we're talking Colours Carnival, and it's going off. I'm very, very blessed to be here. Let's go, it's carnival 2022. Let's move, we're in cover, let's go.
Thank you.
it's a beautiful thing to see how excited everybody is. And I'm personally excited for someone who's never been to Carnival. Like, I feel like I'm a part of something like bigger than anything I've ever been a part of. And me being the graphic designer for a float that will be looked at for like millions of people on the street, I'm grateful. I'm like really, really grateful. I'm coming from a place where there's no carnival at all.
After nearly 3 years of no carnival, this year, I think we had no problems at all. I'm looking forward to 2020.
If you're coming to Carnival with Beam and Havana and the Colours band, you will have the time of your life. This is a group of people, teams that have come together as a family to create the best experience for you. You will be safe, you will have fun, you'll get paint splashed on you by Shivs probably, and you're gonna have the best time ever. Catch us there. Be there, we'll be square.
For Notting Hill Carnival, when masqueraders come out on the road, when we as a team as well, Colours team, we come out on the road, when the sweet soca music on the road hit you there, you know, you're behind the truck, it's as though you transcend. When it starts dying down towards the evening at dusk, it's as though no one wants to go home. But it comes to an end. It comes to an end, yes. But I think more importantly is that we leave there elated. And that takes us through to the rest of the year until the beginning again to Notting Hill Carnival.